violence on the border of Israel overnight. More than 52 people shot dead. Now, it was a striking contrast yesterday. In Jerusalem, Ivanka Trump, daughter of the US president, opened the new US embassy in Jerusalem, moved there from Tel Aviv.
On behalf of the 45th president of the United States of America, we welcome you officially and for the first time to the Embassy of the United States here in Jerusalem, the capital of Israel.
Meanwhile, on Israel's border with Gaza, which is controlled by the Hamas terrorist group, thousands of Palestinians protested against Israel's existence, against its founding 7 years ago, and against the U.S. moving its embassy to Jerusalem, which Palestinians also claim as their capital. Israeli soldiers shot dozens of the protesters near the border fence, including teenagers, and the optics, superficially at least, seem compelling. Here's heavily armed Israelis slaughtering Palestinian civilians, and that's exactly the picture the Palestinian leadership wanted. Palestinian politicians like Mustafa Barghouti are exploiting this, and with some success.
I've met so many ministers, so many prime ministers in the world who always told us, why don't you march peacefully? This is exactly what we are doing.
Excuse me, peaceful protests? Not so. There were the stone throwers, for instance, and groups of potentially armed men hiding behind smoke screens of burning tires, just waiting for the fence to fall, or trying to storm it while throwing Molotov cocktails. And if those thousands of protesters had broken through into Israel, what then? How many Jews would they kill? Poor Jews is no longer popular in many elite circles, and the foreign ministers of France and even Britain Israel and the trigger happened.
It's an extremely sad and violent loss of life that's taken place, and we understand that there are some people who've been provoking that violence, but on the other hand, there's got to be a restraint in the use of life violence.
Donald Trump's White House spokesman, at least, blames Hamas, which controls Gaza, and deliberately incited these protests.
The U.S. not Israeli authorities should exercise discretion and restraint.
We believe that Hamas is responsible.
So there's no responsibility beyond that on the Israeli authorities. Kill or will.
What I'm saying is that we believe that Hamas, as an organization, is engaged in cynical action that's leading to disease.
Our own Prime Minister also sheeted the blame straight to Hamas.
Any loss of life is like this is or any loss of life is tragic in these circumstances, but Hamas's conduct is confrontational, they're seeking to provoke
so the Israeli defense forces.
Well, if you're pushing people to the border in that conflict zone, you're basically pushing people into circumstances where they are very likely to be shot at, as Israel seeks to defend itself.
For a fuller understanding of this confrontation, we do need some background. And we can understand why Israel cannot afford not to defend that fence along its border, even with deadly force. And perhaps it also explains why many Muslim countries are relatively muted in their criticism of what it's done. For one, Hamas is an Islamist terrorist group. Its charter still calls for Israel to be wiped from the map. Jews to be killed. Hamas soldiers have in the past fired many rockets at Israel and dug tunnels under the fence to attack Israeli towns, take hostages. Gaza preachers, even on the Friday before this organized protest, in sermons broadcast on television, called for the destruction of Israel and death for the wicked Jews. In fact, even children in Gaza Gaza are taught by Hamas television to hate Jews and kill them. And the Israeli military says Hamas on a Facebook page urged followers to bring a knife or a gun to yesterday's protests and to try to kidnap an Israeli soldier if the fence did come down. So, to the critics and dreamers who say, why did the Israelis shoot people who simply want a fence torn down? Who say, why not just let more of these Palestinians in Gaza just simply live in Israel? What you're really saying is, let's have all Jews killed. But the Jews of Israel have decided that they will be anyone's favorite victim.